these to the major for a signature.
Jack, we're trying to locate some mail.
What outfit, sir?
2nd Battalion, 143rd Infantry, 36th Division.
What outfit, sir? Sir? Hey, they got these rear echelon boys trained, calling us Sergeant Sir. Great improvement.
Your mail was picked up by your supply sergeant this morning, sir.
I know, but he may have overlooked some. The address was all fouled up.
Why'd you give it to the supply sergeant, huh? I never did trust that guy, Barker. Why didn't you give it to the mail clerk?
Check again, will you?
Yeah. Check again.
What seems to be the trouble here?
Well...
Now, don't move, Dobie. Hey, Rex, help! Help! Help, Rex! Come help me!
Hang on to him, Slim. I'll give you a hand.
Hey, Rex. Who do they think they're kidding with them explosives? Anything planted out there, we'd have been blown higher than a kite.
Come on, let's see what the lieutenant wants us to do with these cattle.
Back like you found it. Those aren't my cattle.
We're just trying to keep them off of that minefield. Who do they belong to?
That's the Flying L brand, the next ranch over.
Thanks, mister.
Well, that's a contraption that's going to replace the cavalry, huh? Looks like a cracker box to me.
It'll hold its own.
You just wait till you try to go through a river or down a steep cliff with it. You wish you had a good horse under you.
Well, Colonel Bigelow, we'll meet him at the camp as soon as we take the cattle where they belong.
Sure thing, Rex.
Must be the guy Colonel Bigelow threatened to send down here. We didn't cooperate with the Army. Man Lewis isn't going to like having his stock run off the free range.
I guess the Army meant business when they told us to get our stock off. I don't like it, neither do the other ranchers. We've been depending on that free range for a long time.
See that herd down there? My family have been raising horses for 5 generations. They've developed the finest stock in the West. They've used them in four wars, not including the Indian uprising.
The ranchers are all having a meeting at Chuck Ramsey's ranch tomorrow. We'll fight that army right to the ground.
Well, it's a lot more than just fighting the army. These tests they're making. If that tank wins out over the cavalry, the army won't be buying any more horses. I'll be out of business and you'll be out of a job.
And that could be.
We've got to delay these tests until I can dispose of all my horses. It means $100,000 to me.
Don't worry, Jensen. I'll go to work on those ranchers and have them so fired up, those tests will never come off.
Nevertheless, I think I'll send Chuck Ramsey over to the army camp tonight and see what's going on.
Your men will find your tent down at the end of the street. And there's the picket line.
Take care of Coco, will you, Clem?
Sure.
Well, sir, everything checks. I can't find any damage. You know, she went right through those charges just about the way we figured.
Well, it looks as if we're on the right track with this design. Oh, hello, Rex.
Good evening, sir.
I've been expecting you. Spike told me about the cattle.
I don't know whether to salute you, sir, or shake hands.
Oh, the handshake will do. Now, let's see, it's been about 4 years since you left the cavalry to follow the rodeos, hasn't it?
Hiya, Rex. Howdy, Spike. Well, I see you got the little iron monster home, all right.
Go on, go right ahead. Give her a good boot. She can take it.
Got a lot of faith in this tank, Rex. That's why I sent for you. The big army brass will be here in a couple of days to witness a cross-country race between the cavalry and this tank.
But where do I fit in?
Well, we selected this open country for the test because of the terrain. Government's been letting the ranchers graze their horses and cattle here for years.
Now they refuse to get them off so that you can go ahead with your test.
Exactly. You and your boys are going to clear the range for them.
Well, the ranchers and I speak the same language. Maybe I can convince them that it's their patriotic duty not to cause any trouble.
You remember Lieutenant Chuck Ramsey?
Yes, sir, very well. Why?
He was court-martialed out of the army for gambling. Coordination. He's got a ranch near here. He's done everything possible to fight the cavalry.
That's tough. You know, Colonel, if this tank proves itself, it won't be the cavalry anymore. It'll be the tank corps.
I know.
I thought you were a dyed-in-the-wool cavalryman.
I am, Rex. Matter of fact, I feel a lot like a cowman turned sheep herder. But this is 1926. All the big powers are experimenting with tanks. But the rest of the times. Lieutenant and I are the only ones who believe the tank has a future.
You'll have a rough time convincing the old-time cavalryman that the horse is finished.
Oh, who goes there?
A friend.
Advance, friend, and be recognized.
Oh, hi,
friend. Hiya, honey.
Did she say friend?
Oh, hello, Colonel Bigelow.
Barry?
Rex, I'd like you to meet Cherry Ramsey.
Hello, Rex.
Oh, not Chuck's little sister.
That's right. No more pigtails, no more dolls, except this one, of course. And no more crying, remember?
4 years have made a big difference.
Chuck's outside. He heard you were coming, and he wanted to say hello to an old buddy.
Why didn't he come in?
I can tell you why. Because I'm here. He still blames me for his court-martial.
Whatever Chuck did, it was his own fault. The court-martial was fair. It's the disease he has that's to blame.
Is he sick?
Yes, a bad case of gambling. We've had a hard time making ends meet this season. And now with the army taking over our free range...
That's only temporary. In a few weeks, this test will be over, and the free range returns to you ranchers.
I know it, but the ranchers don't. They think this is the start of a lot of tests, and that the free range will become a permanent testing ground. As a matter of fact, they're holding a meeting tomorrow morning at our ranch to see what they can do to stop you.
Oh? You should be there, Rex.
I'm not invited.
Well, if you think you can talk any sense into them, you are now.
Thanks, I'll be there. Colonel, with your permission, I'll see Cherry back to her ranch.
By all means.
Thank you.
Good night.
Night.
Oh, Lieutenant.
Yes, sir?
Need any help?
No, sir. This I can handle myself.
Hello, Chuck. Rex. To run us off. I wouldn't be surprised if he and Alan were partners. Cameron's right, Ben. I was in the Army. I ought to know. Well, let's talk it over calmly.
The Army ain't calm about it. They're running my cattle lean.
They're scaring them with their mines and tanks.
And trying to put us off by force.
Yes, and they've got the guns to do it. But we've got guns, too.
But we can't fight the army. We wouldn't have a chance.
Maybe not. But we can make it real uncomfortable for them. Here they come now. Will you ranchers back me up?
Yeah.
I'll show you what I mean.
We're just taking orders from Colonel Bigelow. Rex Allen and his boys have been hired by the colonel to clear the range if you don't start moving your cattle off immediately.
Hear that, men? They're gonna get tough.
Mike!
Black spots is an explosive, and we're supposed to come along here in the tank.
Oh. Well, General Parker, this is Rex Allen.
How do you do?
How do you do, sir?
Take care of those, Lieutenant, will you?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is the route the tank and the troops must follow. The course is plainly laid out with markers through which the contestants must pass. The course leads through this rough terrain, through the stream, through barbed wire, and through a field of explosives with just enough powder to frighten the horses. Of course, we don't expect the tank to be held up by any of these. Rex Allen and his men have been over the course and reported clear of the cattle. That's right, isn't it, Rex?
That's right, sir, but I'd like to take another look before the race starts.
Might be a good idea, Colonel.
All right, it's now 10 o'clock. The maneuvers will start in 30 minutes.
Yes, sir. Good luck to you, Colonel.
Thank you.
Sure wish you and I were riding against that tank.
Don't worry about it, Slim. The boys that are doing the riding are hand-picked. They'll give that tank a race for its money.
Take him on to the doctor, Slim.
It's too late for Spike.